Welcome to Pulpy Tamarind Channel. Today we will see how to make Puliyogarai. So to make that sauce, we need tamarind around lemon sized and dry red chilies as per the spice requirement. Then we require urad dal, chana dal, turmeric powder, mustard seeds, salt, peanuts, roasted peanuts and cashew nuts, curry leaves, sesame oil or til oil, asafoetida, raw rice about a cup. So we require all that to make the tamarind rice. So we are going to make the sauce for tamarind rice. So we are going to make a coarse powder first. For that we need fenugreek seeds, dry red chilies, peppercorns and coriander seeds. Tamarind soaked in water, sesame oil or til oil, curry leaves, roasted peanuts and cashew nuts, asafoetida, mustard seeds, Bengal gram or chana dal, turmeric powder, salt, dry red chilies 5 to 6, raw rice 1 cup, coriander seeds, peppercorns, fenugreek seeds, dry red chilies 5 to 6. We will take a kadai, keep it on medium heat, and once the kadai is hot, we will add one by one all these four ingredients: coriander seeds, dry red chilies 5 to 6, coriander seeds you can take around 2 tablespoons, fenugreek seeds you can take around 1 teaspoon, peppercorns you can take around 1 tablespoon, and dry fry them till they become a bit crisp and start letting out their oils. And then we will blitz it in a blender into a coarse powder and we'll keep this aside. This can be kept for more than 2 weeks if you keep it in an airtight container and used. If you refrigerate it, it can be used for up to 6 months. So this is a powder which is sprinkled over the tamarind rice for additional flavor and taste. So that gives the crunch element, and so you get a different sort of texture while eating the tamarind rice. So this is a separate procedure. This we should do and keep it aside, and then we'll make the sauce. So again, for sauce we need to soak the tamarind. We have around lemon sized tamarind soaked in warm water for some time, and then we can blitz it in a blender and make a fine paste and strain it and keep it aside. So now we're going to blitz it into a coarse powder. So again we'll keep a kadai on the medium heat, and once the kadai is hot, we're going to add the til oil or the sesame oil. We'll add a bit lavishly, around 2 to 3 tablespoons or even a bit more, because that's the oil which is going to give taste to the sauce. So once the oil is hot, we are adding mustard seeds, around a teaspoon, and we need to wait for it to pop or splutter before adding urad dal or the black gram dal and the Bengal gram or the chana dal. Each around a tablespoon can be added, and we'll wait for all of them to get crisped and splutter. So once it starts spluttering, we'll add one by one all the ingredients that are for tempering. So this is black gram, and we'll roast it a bit, and then add chana dal or Bengal gram, and then the ground nuts or peanuts, and the cashew nuts can be for final garnish. So but that also has to be roasted in clarified butter till golden brown and crisp, and kept aside for garnish. So after that we'll add dry chilies broken into 2, around 4 or 5 as per your spice requirement. So now we added the peanuts as well. So we're roasting it all till they become crisp. We added the curry leaves, a handful of it, and that also will give a nice citrusy lemony taste to the sauce. And then we'll add dry red chilies. You can add from 4 to 6 broken into 2. That will give you the spice. and add asafoetida and turmeric powder. So once everything is crisp and nutty and tasty, then we'll switch off the stove first and then add fenugreek seed powder about half a teaspoon, turmeric powder about half a teaspoon, and asafoetida powder also about a half a teaspoon, and mix it all well. And then add the tamarind pulp as per how much we require to make the sauce along with water, and you can switch on the gas again and start making a sauce out of it. So we need to wait for the tamarind and the pulp to cook and the raw smell to disappear and to thicken into a thick sauce. So, and also add salt for the sauce, and that will be your sauce. So we need to wait for the tamarind pulp to cook and thicken and reduce into a sticky, a thick sauce. So that's the stage when you can switch off the gas and your sauce is ready. And you can cook raw rice in less amount of water because we want it to be not overcooked or mushy, and add here. So once everything is added, we will switch on the gas and add the tamarind pulp. So how much tamarind pulp we have to add and how much amount of liquid we need to add depends on how much rice you're going to mix. And then we'll have to wait for the sauce to develop. It has to reduce, it has to cook, the raw smell has to disappear, and it has to become thick. So till then we need to wait, and once that's done, we'll have to add salt for this. And once that's done, we have to switch off the gas and let it cool, and you can add the rice. So I'm again and again repeating raw rice because we have something called boiled rice as well. So the rice which is straight away from fields is raw rice after the husk is removed and polished, and the same rice with the husk before polishing, before removing the husk, you are boiling it about 3/4 stage and then again drying it in hot sun. That's called boiled rice. So it has a rubbery texture to it. So that's another sort of rice which is prepared in India. So that's why I'm asking you to go for raw rice. So the rice which is in the markets, which you get straight from the field after polishing and cleaning and removal of husk, is raw rice. And the one which has gone through a process is called the boiled rice. So cook the raw rice. Tamarind paste is getting ready. So this is the tamarind paste. So to this we'll add the rice. Mix the 3/4 cooked rice. So we'll mix the rice with the sauce. You can mix all of the sauce or a little by little, how much ever you want. You can store the sauce in a jar in room temperature or in the fridge for a longer period. So this is usually done ready made and kept at home. So whenever anybody wants to eat, they can add a bit of sauce to the rice and mix and eat. So that's sort of a ready made thing it is. So here we are mixing the whole of the sauce with the rice, and you can mix lot of sauce and less rice, or less sauce and more rice, as you want the taste. And then you need to sprinkle the coarse powder over this for texture and for a crunch element, and garnish it with cashews and peanuts and your puliyogarai or puli tamarind rice or puli sadam is ready. So this sauce is called puli kachal or puliyogarai, and the rice is called tamarind rice. So this is accompanied usually by a toyal specifically made for this. So this is something which is very much a staple recipe, and this is usually given as offerings to gods and goddesses in temple and to the devotees after it is offered to the gods. So this is the tasty puli sadam or puliyogarai. You also please try it. Please support, subscribe, share, and press the bell icon for notifications. Thank you for watching Pulpy Tamarind Channel.